Solder them. So this antenna is soldered on. You either want to solder it off or you can simply just leave it alone. There's a connector here. Release that. And then you can pry it up. See it? Connector. And leave this on the side so you can get to it later. Continue disassembling the larger board. Okay, I think everything is off except this antenna. Maybe I'll have to take it out later. But aside from that, for the most part, the larger board should be loose. Should be able to pry it up using the SIM card side and it's a leverage. You see this little thing? I'm not sure. This is a little connector to the friend and the camera. It's in between, so I actually need to make the camera frame move a little bit. And I think this point is actually part of the camera frame, so I'm gonna take it off just in case. Maybe I get to it later. And draw the picture on your mat, on the project mat. The pro mat. So this is what it looks like. It's just a piece of ribbon. And the camera is loose. I don't think the camera comes off on its own. You will have to definitely pry it up. It does come off. There's a little release clamp here, two of them, and then just click into this two holes, two indentations, and the camera comes off. This is the iPhone 6 Plus camera. Don't get the lens dirty. Hold it without touching it. Okay, put that aside. And now the larger board should come loose on its own. As you can see here, there is a little metal piece here. You either take it off or you can slide it upward then get it off. There is a ribbon cable up here that was connected to the fan. I'm considering leaving it alone, but I may have to unscrew this later. It does comes off. It's just another connector signal holder. This ribbon looks pretty fragile, so you don't want to damage it. You are able to take the screws out and disassemble it, but I chose not to because I'm gonna have to put it back anyway. So today, my objective is take everything off on the board. Now you can see this is the Apple power management integrated chip, and it's oscillator here, coil. Okay, so before I do that, I need to take all the non-essential parts completely off the board. That being said, I need to get this off. This is it has a little jumper wire here connecting two boards. Be careful, you can damage it if you pry it too hard. Alright. And always remember to put this part back to the board before you put it back together. Last time I put it back together, I forget, and then how they went back. Then put that back. So another interesting is what's under the shield. This is where the larger board CPU is at. And what I need to do now is I'm gonna have to use a the octopus clamps to help me secure the board in order to apply hardware on it. So I'm going to be doing a little bit of soldering, and that should help me to get the boards off. So for iPhone 6 Plus, pretty big phone, larger board itself is not bigger than iPhone 6. I'm gonna try to do this with only hot air. See if it can be done. It's gonna be hard because I have to watch the sign. Because it's very difficult to do this with only one hand. Having the camera in the field. I will be able to heat this up. Maybe not. I do need help. I'm gonna use a little bit of QuickAlloy. Speed things along and get some flux going. Really can be a lot easier if you soften the joints first before you go all the way. Vacuum expression going. I don't actually want too much of this because you can get inside the frame and cause a problem. So just a little bit. Okay. And the rest you can use the hot air gun to do. giving. So be careful. Now the entire frame is heated up as it should. Now it's going. Okay, it's done. There we go. It's taken off. Wasn't that bad. Now working on to sussing the pores, anything. No, everything's fine. Now we can work on the other side of the metal shielding. This is also always easier to take it off because it's just covering so much of it. Very easily on its own. Actually quite pretty. So now it's very hot. Hold it for a second. Probably should wear a glove for this. Burn myself. I'm gonna scratch off this black stuff if you can. It's gonna get in the way from the heating. It's very important now to really heat up on the side so it will make the whole process easier. Okay. I think I want to do it on the cover of the plastic parts. Really a lot more heating than is necessary. Right. The other side. It's a little bit good, you know? Yeah, I should do it. Seems to be a silicone shielding on top of this heatsink. It's cracking on top. Okay, so I'll cover this. Take the battery connector. This is the memory chip, right here.
thank you for watching. We'll be back for the reassembly video.